Dr. G,
yes,
because you made a video. Do you know what's funny about it? While I was speaking to
people, have you actually watched the video?
Yeah, I watched it.
What's your opinion of the video?
It was a lot of nonsense.
It was a lot of nonsense. Okay,
yeah. I'm gonna prove it. Yeah.
Who is Adam?
I'm here. Adam. Here. We have the books. We have everything.
I'm getting tired of debating the Madkhalis.
No.
Imam Hussein is wrong. Imam Malik.
Okay.
I know the argument.
Okay. First of all, before you know the argument. Okay. Please. Khalas. We're having a talk, please.
Okay, just 1 minute till I go.
No. He's my sidekick.
It's not a joke.
They advise Imam Hussein don't go to Karbala.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean
to Kufa,
you are
no, Karbala, to Kufa.
No. It doesn't mean you are wrong.
No, it was,
but he advised him don't go to Karbala.
Because
they don't trust the people in Karbala. Don't trust them.
Okay.
It doesn't mean that you are wrong, give bay'ah to Yazid.
No,
they know that the bay'ah of Yazid is not
true. Why when I want to speak to someone else?
Okay. Do you want to have a discussion with him instead?
No, to you, because you... Okay, please.
Habibi, ma tkhafsh. Hanzabato.
It's not a joke, it's deen, yo. This deen...
Madkhali fried chicken today.
No, it's beyond me, you know.
Sorry.
This deen is not a joke, okay? Because you're taking it as a joke.
It isn't a joke, but you guys have made it into a joke.
No, it's not.
Okay, first of all, can we agree that...
Let me speak, akhi.
Is going against Al-Hakim, Al-Muslim, wrong or not?
We're not going to speak about this first. Let us analyze something.
Okay.
Let us start with the foundation. We have the books here. All your speech was misquotes. We have your papers with us. We took picture of it. That you misquotes. And you think it's funny. That is the deen of Allah. It's just Magenta.
Dr. G.
Adam, Imam.
Yes. Imam Dr. G. Okay.
Listen carefully. So... You addressing me, said Shamsi was hiding from me.
No, this was before.
Yeah, I understand.
Should I clarify that?
Wait. Before you came to the camera, did you approach me?
I waited. You were debating some people.
No, did you approach me?
No. I did wave at you, but maybe you didn't see.
I didn't see you.
Okay.
So I was not hiding from you?
No, but I thought you were. That's
right. I was not.
I'm happy to clarify that you did debate me afterwards.
Yeah.
It was in a private conversation.
Yeah, but...
Which you wish to make public now.
Yeah, I'm going to... You know why? Because you spread... a lot of things which misunderstood, you misused it, misexplained it. The other thing that is funny, because last week, as I have mentioned, five people were coming after me.
Yes.
One of them already clarified he never had intention to come and debate me. It was a Jewish man who came, and his boys came to me, said, Shamsi, our friend came down, he will speak to you. Another guy, paper boy, while I was speaking...
What is the purpose of this conversation?
We're going to come wait. It's funny. When I was speaking to paper boy, he was saying that he was speaking to the camera, saying Shamsi is hiding from me.
No, you were not around.
Yeah, wait.
But was he around?
Let me finish.
Last week we did not see him.
Let me speak.
I was with this brother, he can testify. We did not see him.
Let me finish my point. When I left paper boy, because paper boy, he stopped me to ask me questions.
I don't have your itinerary. I'm not your PA. I don't have your schedule of when you debate. What is the purpose of this conversation?
To clarify to you people that you're lying against
me. Can you refute my innovation?
This
is what I want. I'm here
for.
I didn't even want to debate you, Saraha, because khalas, I think we've had enough of
Madkhalism.
No,
wait, please.
Yeah.
There's no something called
Madkhalism. Debate Rabi'i al-Madkhali, the warlord Rabi'i al-Madkhali.
You're Shia, they call us Bakri. Is that true?
What?
Shia, they call
us Bakri. I've debated plenty of Shia.
But I ask you that. There's the point of speaking to you. Wallahi. Anyway, I clarified it.
Yaki, do you have a point or not? So far, it's you debate the paper boy or paper girl. What's this got to do with me?
If you allow me,
yes.
If you'll be patient, that won't...
Khas, Bakri, Sadri, see what
says here, actually. Yeah, we are Bakri, yeah.
Yes. We're not Bakri. We are full.
Yaki, I never said I'm Bakri.
This name, is invented name. No, we don't accept it. Okay. Step by step, okay.
Yeah.
You mentioned a point. Use the verse. وَلَا تَرْكَنُوا إِلَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا فَتَمَسَّكُمُ النَّارِ.
I use many.
No. Step by step. Get the phone.
I know.
No, I'm going to show you.
Yeah, I know. Okay.
So that verse, which scholars use that verse from the Mufassir of the past?
Why did I use that verse?
You used it for to rebel.
No, I didn't. No. I said that, I was very clear with my, let me clarify, this is a good point. He's claiming that I use this verse to directly say that we can rebel. Of course, this is
evolution.
Not true.
Use evolution.
Evolution, no.
Revolution.
Revolution. Revolution. I did not use this. The verses in the Quran do not say revolution. I want to make this clear. The verses in the Quran are telling us to be vigilant and stand up and not to be in the circle of oppressors. So it was establishing a foundation that Islam at its very core is against oppression. And I believe the verses pointed that out. The ahadith and the actions of the Salaf and the actions of Rabi' al-Madkhali say that we should do khuruj against the ruler.
So first of all, clearly you said, you mentioned the verse, then you said this is a revolution against oppression. Islam teaches us to be...
If you go back to the video,
you can clearly see
these verses... Yeah.
So this verse is a general verse, correct?
Against oppression, yes.
Without any doubt. No one here will tell you to defend oppression.
Okay, I wasn't. It was. Yeah. I was.
No. Wait, step by step, because I want to deal with every point.
Yeah.
So that verse is a general verse, correct?
Amen.
But your aim was what? To show that it's permissible to rebel and to do revolution.
Yeah, if I stop there, it would be wrong. But I continued.
So let us understand, make it clear to everyone.
Yes.
Because what I want some people to know, they say, Shamsi, why are you speaking by yourself? Why don't go to the brother and speak to him? Some people...
We did speak.
Alhamdulillah. Some people are not running away from them. Some people are donkeys. I don't waste my time with the donkeys. So I leave them. Because I spoke to them before. Not you, of course. I'm talking about some people before. I spoke to them many times. They don't listen. So me walking off doesn't mean I'm scared. Me, I'm a wise man. I don't want to waste my time with a foolish man. That's what it means. But you hopefully, inshallah, today, after showing you the Adilla, you will take it back. Use the other verse, okay?
When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala... But there's no point in going verses when I told you why I
used
verses.
I want to do it every point.
Okay.
Okay. The verse when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the person who's been oppressed.
Yeah.
That verse has nothing to do if a leader oppresses you.
It does.
No, it doesn't. Do you know what it doesn't?
Or any oppression in general.
Do you know what it doesn't? There's hadith in Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim. Okay? The Messenger of Allah said, there will be leaders. They will take your right from you. And they will ask you their rights from you.
Yes.
So they say, oh, Messenger of Allah, should we not fight them?
Yes.
Should we know what?
I know the hadith.
If they take your rights from you, is that oppression?
But I also showed you a hadith
I'm going to
fight them. Yeah.
No. All these hadith you mentioned, I have them there.
Even kill them as well.
No. Yeah. I'm showing you this hadith. The hadith is a Muslim doesn't speak about the Umara. Doesn't matter. You mentioned Al Khalaf. Who said that? Qadi Iyaz. So I'm going to show you. First of all, let's lay down. Are you a scholar, by the way?
No, are you?
No, I'm not. Are you layman, Muslim layman?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Both us, we agree we're a Muslim layman.
Yes.
So all of us to understand the deen, we go with the Quran,
yes.
Prophetic tradition, yes. To the Salaf and the scholars.
And that's what I did.
Okay, yes, now yes. Let's go step by step. Now, you mentioned a hadith. You mentioned the story of who? Abdullah ibn Zubayr, ibn al-Awam.
Yes, and Imam al-Hussein. And I would add the third one is the Tawabin revolution.
No, yeah. Tawabin, which is... No one speaks about it.
It's a Sahabi. No one speaks about it. About it.
Okay.
It was done by a Sahabi.
Abdullah ibn Zubayr. Did he give a bayah to Yazid?
I don't believe that he did, no. The Ummah did.
Did the people of Mecca give bayah to Yazid?
I believe the majority of the Ummah of Muhammad gave bayah
to Yazid. I said, did people
including
of Mecca?
Including Mecca. The majority gave bayah to Yazid.
Mecca never gave.
Prove to me that they didn't.
Because he went there.
They were given by force.
No, just don't repeat what he's saying.
It's true. Yazid was the Khalifa of the Muslims.
I'm not asking you, Yazid, because people of.
Wait. Okay. So you're saying because Ahl al Mecca, which is not true, by the way, but Ahl al Mecca.
No. Not all of them. All of them, they'll get back to Muslims.
Okay. So it's like saying if Muhammad bin Salman.
Muhammad bin Salman.
No. Let me give you a scenario that you know.
Let me finish my point.
No, but let me just clarify the point with you.
You cut me. Look, you cut me. Before finishing my point.
If Mohammed bin Salman takes over as the leader of Saudi Arabia and a province in Saudi Arabia doesn't give him bay'ah, that khalas, it's okay for them to not give him bay'ah.
I didn't say that.
You will advocate killing them, please.
I didn't say that.
Yeah.
He's not khawar, just leave it, alhamdulillah. I'll clarify that for you.
Okay, what's this?
Because why? Clearly, you just speaking.
Okay, can we just establish something? Is your opinion, because my opinion is there's ikhtilaf.
Give the book of the Salaf.
Wait.
I'm going to give you the book of the Salaf, you read it.
Okay, Habibi.
No, Habibi.
No, Habibi. You don't get it. There is different.
Don't all of them. All of
don't
them.
Tell me Barbahari.
No,
don't tell me Barbahari.
Who's that?
Imam Harb ibn Ismail al-Karmani.
Okay. Who is he? Who is he?
He's a scholar of the Salaf.
No, it's circle.
Yeah.
Okay, read what he said here.
But you don't get it. There is a difference.
No. Wait.
You can give me Imam Nawawi. You can give me Hassan al-Basri.
Wait.
You're missing the point. The point is, I'm saying it's
point.
A legitimate
Islamic
difference.
There is no ikhtilaf. No, there is no.
Wallahi, there's a
there
ikhtilaf.
There is no ikhtilaf.
So what's Hassel Ba'a?
Read it, read it.
No, you don't get it. Anything you...
Brother, my brother is for everyone. This
because I can give you equal... I can give you Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani.
No, Ibn Hajar...
Yeah. Wallahi, yeah. Ibn Hajar said you can.
No, I have Ibn Hajar. Let me read Ibn Hajar what he said.
I read you, yeah.
No. You misquote Ibn Hajar.
I misquoted
you read two
that.
Words. Yes. Okay. I'm reading for you today.
Is
today,
it, you're saying
to show you that you have
the problem. The problem is, you are not following the Sunni creed.
No.
You are, bro, I tell you what the Sunni creed is.
Why are you scared of these books?
I'm not scared. They're
no madkhali.
But it's a fallacy.
They're no madkhali.
You're just trying to show up.
These books, no show up.
Yes, you can give me 10. I can give you 10. We're going to go around in circles.
I will challenge you. Look, in front of everyone. I will challenge you to show me one of the books of the Salaf of the Aqidah, not Tariq.
It's not an Aqidah issue, that's the problem.
Okay, so why is mentioning here?
It's not an Aqidah issue, that means Imam Hussein is a Mubtada,
so,
it's an Aqidah issue.
Look, again.
Imam Malik, is Imam Abu Hanifa a Mubtada or not?
There's a lie against Abu Hanifa, it's a lie.
It's what do you mean it's a lie?
I'll tell you what it means.
It's a lie.
Abu Mati'ah, al-Balkhi, Abu Hanifa, mentioned in his book, al-Fiqh al-Kabir, he, al-Fiqh al-Akbar, he said, I asked Abu Hanifa about rebelling. He said, don't rebel. I said, why? Even though Allah told us to enjoy good. No. There's a
lie. And Hassan Basri joined the rebellion.
Look, change the subject. No.
The point
you
is,
me. Oh, no.
You don't get it.
Now, Abu Hanifa, Hassan Basri, tomorrow he's going to send me Tony Blair. He keep moving from names. No.
Imam Malik. Okay, you don't like Abu Hanifa. Imam Malik.
So,
Imam Malik got flogged. Why did he
brothers,
get flogged?
Brothers,
why did he get flogged?
Because clearly you can see...
Rabi' al-Madkhali, why is he supporting revolution?
Okay.
You don't get it. Condemn
so look,
these people
yourself.
First.
Take care. That's it.
You can't.
Because he's just debating here for everyone to know.
It's very admirable that you got a bunch of books from your...
Can I speak?
I gave the sources in the video.
No.
He's got the checks about.
Here. Ikhwa, look this one, yeah?
He's not answering one of my sources. What about...
Listen.
Al-Barbahari, don't give me Al-Barbahari, please.
Why?
Because Al-Barbahari says, he claimed Usma in his book. He said, if you criticize one of my letter in my book, you go to hellfire.
No,
that's arrogance.
Look. Yeah. Ikhwa,
he did say
again,
that.
Again, misquoting Al-Barbahari.
Can
read the
Al-Barbahari
context.
Said there's things ijma' that don't... Yeah, ijma'.
Look, Ikhwa.
He made stuff up, I'm sorry.
Again, show you...
We don't
look,
worship
people of this size, innovation, I'm after you. You are kadabun liars. I'm here. Now, someone said, I shall debate
Jubair,
me.
Was
I'm
your
here
innovator?
Speak as corner.
Was Sa'id ibn Jubair an innovator?
Again, Sa'id ibn Jubair. Can I answer it? Okay. Sa'id ibn Jubair, Imam al-Nawawi mentioned, the reason they rebelled against Hajjaj, because they believed he was...
Imam al-Nawawi had an opinion. Okay, sorry. Khalas, erga.
Don't talk to them directly. Don't talk in the background like a little chicken. This one, he called us, they called me a Nazi, we were just silly.
Nasibi.
Well, you think Imam, you're not a Nasibi, but you do hate Imam Hussein for rebelling against Yazid.
Who doesn't hate
you? You say there are Saudi scholars who say Yazid, including Sheikh al-Sheikh, he said Yazid has a right to kill al-Hussein.
Sa'id al-Jubair, Imam al-Nawawi mentioned that the reason they rebelled against him, because they believed, he fell into disbelief. And there's a clear hadith of what Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, if the leader falls into disbelief, you allow to rebel with the condition al-Qudra.
So if I say...
No, wait. No. Stop.
Okay.
Stop.
Did you not let me... Then,
no, stop. You asked me about Sa'id ibn Jubair, did you?
Yes, but you haven't answered it properly.
Let him finish.
So Nawawi has answered it properly.
Okay, I'll tell you, I'll explain to you. There are a minority of scholars who did say al-Hajjaj is a kafir. And of course, if someone, one of us said Muhammad bin Salman is a kafir, you guys will say we're taking.
Don't change subject.
No, I'm just using your logic.
Sa'id ibn Jubair, okay. What did he rebel? Yeah.
Sa'id ibn Jubair, some of them did believe he was a kafir. Others believed he was a fasiq.
No,
he was not a kafir.
I didn't ask you that. Sa'id ibn Jubair, yeah. And those who rebel against Hajjaj.
Not all of them believe he's a kafir.
No, wait. Where is your proof?
Because not all of them, but you'd have... No, it's the other way around.
No.
Because Al-Hajjaj was known...
No. It was known that he delayed prayer. He was
he
known...
He did pray.
No, he delayed salawat.
He would love the Quran. He helped... He spent his... He devoted his life...
So you know Al-Hajjaj now. He did Al-Hajjaj now.
Wallahi, subhanallah. With Madkhali's leads.
No, wait. Can you define what is Madkhaliya?
I'll tell you what Madkhaliya is. It's a good question. Madkhaliya
is why?
An offshoot of Salafi Islam.
Fight expose him.
I explain. Madkhaliya is an offshoot of Salafi Islam that has two characteristics that deviate from Sunni Islam. The first one is that they believe in excessively obedience to the ruler and it's a matter of asl al-deen. This is not Islam. Secondly, wait. Madkhaliya is characterized by chain tabdiyah. من لم يبدع فهو مبتدع.
So basically,
this is similar to the Khawarij. Ask for Asl al-Din, the Khalifa bin Asl al-Din, this is similar to the Shia, because they believe Imama is from a religious matter. The Madkhaliya also believe that the Imama of the Muslimin is somehow a Aqidah issue, when it's not at all. It's
okay, so now he mentioned two characteristics. He said the Madkhaliya, they believe that Khuruj al-Hakim in Usul al-Din.
You know, he said, yeah, excessive.
Okay. Karmani, he mentioned from Usul al-Din. Karmani was 1,000 years before Sheikh Rabi'. So is Madkhali to you?
No, there's a difference.
Okay, wait, hold this. Okay, wait. Al-Muzani. Al-Imam al-Muzani. Do you know Muzani?
Yes, I do.
Student of Imam Shafi'i.
Yes.
Okay, he mentions from Usul al-Din.
You're basically quoting scholars.
Wait, step by step, to see that you are a person, khitabit person.
Okay.
Okay, may Allah guide us and guide you. Okay, al-Muzani.
It's a pointless exercise.
No, because what? That's your argument. Your argument,
I'm very clear of my choice. Okay, the excessive obedience.
Wait.
We all as Muslims believe that we should obey ulil amr minkum if he's a believer, if he's a
hakim. Book again. In this book said, even if he was evil. In this book, he said, even if he was evil. In this book, let us see who's he. Sabuni. Imam Sabuni said, even if he was evil, he's a madkhali to him. You know the story might be of someone called Imam al-Bukhari Wahhabi. You know, wallahi, he's Imam al-Bukhari is Wahhabi. So this guy, according to him, the Armad Khali. Rada, barakallahu fiqh, Imam al-Ajurri. So one thing now. Now, when the Messenger of Allah said in the hadith,
yes,
which is Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim.
But you didn't respond to the hadith about
One of the hadith is Sahih Muslim.
Yes.
Qadhi Iyad said about it.
Yes.
You know, he said that hadith is not talking about the leaders. Rather, this hadith talking about if you are scholar, for example, and you allow it to change the evil that is occurring.
Are you talking about jahadahum biyadihi?
Biyadihi, yeah.
That is talking about the leader.
No. It's not you go to the leader. Mean if something's happening there and you are able because you are a scholar, you are a person of status, you are...
When can you criticize the leader then? No, I would like to know the Madkhali usul of criticizing the leader.
If you allow me to finish my points, then, because what you're doing here, clearly everyone can see. He asked me one question. When I was about to answer it, he would jump another question.
You're talking 90% of the time, you do realize that.
You know why? Because you are accusing us of something. And now when a person goes to court and they put me in a box of witness,
It's good to know you're a witness.
No, witness. I mean, now because you're accusing us, I want to show people are lying against us. Because they cannot refute us with knowledge.
Makhali is a well-known sect.
It's like a Bakri, like Shia. Shia said Bakri is a sect.
No, please.
Same thing. Wahhabi, do you accept there's Wahhabi sect?
No, I don't.
Khalas. But do people say Wahhabi sect there is?
Yeah, because they're misguided. They don't
but you're one of them. Inshallah, Allah guide you. Naam, you say Rabb Madkhali.
What a pointless discussion.
Okay, no. I'm just showing you here, and I will finish with this, that Ikhwa, leave Shamsi's speech.
Do you go condemn Rabb Madkhali for overthrowing the leader?
Let me finish my points.
Because he's not avoiding the point.
No, I'm not.
Practically, are you against Khuruj? No, how come your scholars do Khuruj?
Let me finish my point. I'll explain to you that.
Okay, you'll explain. Rabbi al-Madkhali doing Khuruj against President Sarraj.
Okay, which is nonsense here. Let me finish. And now, brother, Zif Shamsi's speech. Naam. Go, Usul Sunnah Imam Ahmed Hanbal. Shah Sunnah Imam Barbahari. Shah Sunnah Imam Muzani.
There's ikhtilaf on this issue.
No. Bro, I don't want
to. You are saying there's no ikhtilaf.
Let me finish. Yeah. Anyway, subhanak Allah, bihamdik,
look at this. Condemn Rabbi al-Madkhali. Okay.
Sheikh Rabi Azwan, Haftar.
The warlord.
Haftar. Okay. Yeah. Haftar, when the rebellion happened, Naam, when Gaddafi was killed.
Is there a president of Libya? No, I just, because they don't know the Libya situation. You have
I don't know who's Haftar now. Is in the
Libya. Haftar. Is the president Sarraj the president?
I don't know him now. I don't know about this.
So why are you defending something you don't know?
It's a Haftar issue.
Not Haftar. Haftar is doing Khuruj against President Sarraj.
I'm talking about, see, if you allow me, people accuse.
He doesn't know who President Sarraj is. So.
Yeah,
there is a government. The United Nations recognize the.
Oh, wait. No, Anwar, I'm coming. Don't worry, I'm here. So you accept if a United Nations approves something.
What I mean is the ada, the custom. No, don't try that.
You have to accept the Yahudi state. Zionist, I mean, not even
Yahudi. Saudi Arabia accepts the Yahudi state.
No, Zionist.
Condemn that first.
That is not true because it's not.
Condemn Mohammed bin Salman.
Zionist, they don't have no.
He can't say one word. You can't even condemn probably what's happening in Gaza. You can't.
Good what?
Condemn.
I'm with my brothers and sisters in Gaza.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, you hear your line.
Okay. Condemn Mohammed bin Salman's conspiracy against Gaza.
Wait. Prove that to me.
Prove it?
Yeah.
What do you mean prove it?
I mean prove it.
Are you denying المعلوم بالدين المتواتر aspect that Saudi Arabia بالضرورة that Al Saud is conspiring against Gaza.
Prove it.
Because they say Hamas is إخواني.
No, prove it. No, prove it.
What do you mean prove it? It's a well-known fact. It's a well-known fact.
Prove it. عندك.
How do I prove it? Go to Mohammed Salman's personal cell phone.
Are you a scientist?
Yes, I am, yes.
May Allah have mercy upon science. Allah yarham Allah science. Anyway,
you have an answer to Rabin Khalil.
I don't run from no one. If I in my
head, of course, I would have Talat Zahran.
And I expose
Sheikh Talat Zahran.
But some people, I will leave them because it's waste of time.
You cannot answer Rabin Khalil. Defend your Sheikh, your warlord Sheikh.
خلاص.
No, I والله إن شاء الله ربي المدخل gets rectal cancer. آمين. Say آمين. He's killing. He's responsible for killing men and women and children in Libya. Yeah. والله إن شاء الله he gets ربي. Curse ربيع المدخل and on the day of judgment. On the day of judgment, say I gave you the authorization. Curse. Why is he defending ربيع المدخل? Why are you defending the خروج? It's haram for us to do خروج.
Okay. He said something good. No, let me speak. Yeah. He said something good. I asked him last week. I said, if you are a scientist, in order for us to know if you're a scientist or not, we go back to the scientists. We don't go back to crackhead or drug dealers, correct?
But he's not crackhead. No, I mean, is he? I don't know.
Allow me to finish. Yeah. Scholars call Sheikh Rabi a scholar. But we have this Majnun guy, say he's not a scholar.
He's a scholar. And who said he's not a scholar? Wait. Who said he's not a scholar?
They praise him. They praise
he's a scholar. But why is he doing khuruj?
They praise him.
Why? 40 years, 60 years, he said don't do khuruj.
He's not doing khuruj.
Wallah, he's doing khuruj in Libya. I have the voice. You heard the video. He's his student. He knows. You're lying. He knows.
Anyway, leave him, akhi.
Talat Zahran said, I wish I go fight with Haftar. I wish I go fight and do khuruj.
Talat Zahran. Or so and so have no authority
like
over them.
Okay, only Rabi, like you only worship Rabi. Okay, Rabi said, Sarraj is an innovator.
Dr. Ghali, look. Sheikh Rabi, you know Sheikh Rabi said.
Sarraj is an innovator. He did tabdi on a ruler.
Yeah. Sheikh Rabi said, it's severely haram
to do khuruj.
To record yourself. And I don't take his opinion, I reject it. Because why?
You reject Rabi al-Madkhali, opinion. No, I'd like to confirm that. That's a big thing.
If you allow me to finish,
yes.
Then you can hear me.
Yes.
Me, I don't accept Sheikh Rabi's opinion, Hafidah Allah, concerning the camera. Why? Because I accept Sheikh Salah Sheikh.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Sheikh Bambas. Opinion. Do you understand that? Yeah. So anyone claimed that black for Sheikh Rabi is a liar.
Okay, good.
Sheikh
Rabi, so condemn him.
No.
Condemn him for rebelling against the president.
No. You're lying against Sheikh Rabi. You're lying against Sheikh Rabi. You just lied against Salman. Ibn Salman. You lied against Hadith.
Salman. Ibn Salman. He can't defend. He can't defend.
He
likes Kamila. Yeah, he can't. Rabi al-Madkhali, we all know he's overthrowing the government. We all know he's overthrowing. Yeah.
We know
the line for the and he goes there, it's haram for us to overthrow him.
He's 80 or 90 years old.
He took me by the corner and said, shit.
Content over everything. From your belly.
Man, say it straight. Man, don't listen to BBC. Man, don't listen to ITV.
Listen. Last week, Allah, 5 people were looking for
him.
But literally, you can even see the camera. There was a Jewish man who came, who said he was debating. Then, after the Jewish man, another brother who came, people say he wants to be a Chelsea. Then, paper boy, he is looking for me.